Water bath. A water bath is a laboratory equipment which can heat up water to a desired temperature as well as maintain it. All water baths have a digital or an analog interface to allow users to set a desired temperature. It is used to incubate samples in water at a constant temperature over a long period of time. For general clinical laboratory use, constant temperature water baths must offer variable temperature control from 5 degrees centigrade to 100 degrees centigrade with accurate control to plus minus 0.2 degrees centigrade. Water baths are made of steel and are generally covered with electrostatic paint with high adherence and resistance to environmental laboratory conditions. Water baths have an external panel on which the controls can be found. They also have a tank made of rust-proof material with a collection of electrical resistors mounted on their lower part. By means of these, heat is transferred to the medium, which is water, till it reaches the temperature selected with a control device like thermostat. Types of water bath. They can be classified based on resistors, which may be of the following types. External, where the resistors are located on the lower part but on the outside of the tank. These are protected by an isolating material which prevents heat loss. This type of resistor transfers the heat to the bottom of the tank through thermal conduction. Immersion type. Here, the resistors are installed inside a sealed tube and located on the lower part of the container in direct contact with heating medium. Other components can be installed, for example, a thermometer and an agitation unit to keep the temperature constant. Maintenance of a constant temperature is improved by filling the water bath with distilled water. This prevents the accumulation of mineral deposit from regular tap water, which can affect the temperature sensing elements and generally lead to poor heat transfer. However, if an accumulation of these minerals occurs, a weak hydrochloric acid solution will dissolve the deposits. Operation. Install the water bath close to an electrical outlet. Its installation and use is facilitated by a sink close by for supplying and draining of water. Verify that the location selected is level. Ensure that the location has a suitable amount of space for putting the samples and the accessories required. Avoid placing the water bath where there are strong air currents which can interfere with its normal operation. Avoid placing it close to an air conditioner which can interfere in its temperature control. Maintenance. Use and care of a water bath. Water baths are equipment whose maintenance is simple. Read the manufacturer's instruction. Prepare written SOPs covering the use, care, and maintenance of the water bath. The most common routines are outlined below. The monthly maintenance. Turn off and disconnect the equipment. Wait until it cools to avoid the risk of burns and accident. Remove the water used for heating. Remove the thermal diffusion grid located at the bottom of the tank. Disassemble the circulator and clean to remove scale and potential algae present. Clean the interior of the tank with a mild detergent. If there is any indication of corrosion, use substances for cleaning stainless steel. Rub lightly with synthetic sponges or equivalent. Avoid using steel wool to remove rust stains as these leave particles of steel which could accelerate corrosion. Avoid bending or striking the temperature control capillary tube generally located at the bottom of the tank. Clean the exterior and interior of the water bath with clean water. Precautions for using a water bath. As water baths are generally heated to physiological temperatures, they can become breeding grounds for algae, fungi, and bacteria. Heating it to over 60 degrees for 30 minutes will thermally disinfect the bath. Alternatively, chemical disinfectants compatible with the model may be used. An example is methylate or thiomersal at a dilution of 1 in 1,000. Before incubating samples, check that the temperature of water is correct. Ensure that the level of water is 4 to 5 centimeters from the top of the tank. Use the lid to prevent loss of heat from the bath and to minimize particles from entering the water. When removing the lid after incubation, take care to avoid any water entering the uncapped tubes. Wherever possible, use capped tubes. Clean the water bath regularly, taking care not to damage the heating unit. If there is a buildup of scale on the heater and sides of the bath, this can be removed by using juice of a lemon or filling the bath with 10% citric acid and leaving it till the deposit has dissolved. Unplug the bath from the wall socket when not using it, when there is an electrical storm, and when cleaning the water bath and carrying out any maintenance work.
Every 3 to 6 months, check the bath for corrosion, the power cable for wear, and the plug for any loose connection.
Avoid deionized water as it induces leaching and hard water as it induces scaling. Regularly adding water will replenish oxygen and maintain protective layers. Calibration.
The calibration involves checking the temperature of the water bath at different temperature ranges.
The temperature should be checked using a calibrated thermometer traceable to a NABL accredited testing laboratory. Remember, it is important to verify the temperature in different zones of the water bath. Safety. Avoid the use of water bath in environments where there are flammable and combustible materials, as the resistors generating very high temperatures could start an accidental fire or explosion. Use the water bath exclusively for non-corrosive or non-flammable liquids. Use personal protective elements when working with the water bath. The bath has resistors which can cause burns if inadvertently touched, even a considerable time after turning off the equipment. Remember that liquids incubated in water bath can produce burns if hand is inadvertently placed inside it. Avoid using the water bath if any of its control is not working. For example, the temperature limit controls.